Welcome to Filmora Pro. My name is Johnny, and today we'll be taking a look at whip pans. Whip pans? That's right, whip pans. So, what is whip panning? Whip panning is a transition when your camera pans really quick between two shots. So quick, in fact, that you get tons of motion blur in the process. This is often used to hide cuts between two different shots or signify a tonal shift. We've used whip pans before. For example, I used one in our last tutorial where I switched from our tutorial setup to a skit. So, how do you make a whip pan? Well, there's two ways you can do it. You can pull it off in camera, and you can also pull it off entirely in Filmora Pro. First, let's look at how you can capture it in camera. The most important thing to keep in mind when shooting whip pans is to know which way the camera is going. Are you whipping from the left to the right, or from the right to the left? Whatever you decide, make sure to write it down so you don't forget it, because you're going to have to pull this off twice. In this case, we'll whip the camera from the left to the right. So, first thing to do is get your first shot and end it by panning really quickly from the left to the right. Most tripods will let you pan pretty quickly, but if you don't have a good tripod, you can also pull this effect off handheld. Next, get your second shot all focused and framed up. Before beginning the action, pan your camera to the left and then really quickly pan it into the frame. Then you can start your next bit. Be patient, because this might take a few tries to get right. Now to edit these two shots together. Let's line them both up chronologically on our timeline. We'll want to trim both of them down about halfway through the pan. Finally, we'll line them both up, and there we go. Now, if things are still not lining up smoothly, you can also go to the effects panel and drag a cross-dissolve transition onto the cut between your two clips. You'll probably want to make it a really quick transition, though, by shortening the transition down. Let's take a look at that. Perfect. But what if you didn't shoot a whip pan in camera? You just want to add the effect in post. Just like I did right here, actually. Well, let me show you how. Adding whip pans in Filmora Pro is actually really easy. Simply line two clips up that you want to whip pan between. Next, in the effects panel under Transitions, Video, Motion, drag the push effect onto your clips. Right off the bat, you'll have a whip pan-like effect, but I think we should have it switch between the shots faster. To do this, let's zoom in on our timeline and drag our transition inwards to make it shorter. Much better. If we click on the effect, we'll be able to control which direction the whip pan goes in, and how much motion blur there is during the pan. I recommend experimenting and finding what works most naturally for you. Finally, depending on what sort of tone you want to go with for your whip pan, you might want to use a swooshing sound effect. There are a few available on film stocks that you can get for free if you search up whoosh. Link in the description. Once you have your sound effect, line it up with your clip so that the peak of the audio waveform lines up with the cut. Let's take a look at that. There we go! So, that's a look at how you can add whip pans into your shots. Now, if you want to learn about adding other kinds of camera movement to your shots, we recently made another tutorial dedicated just to that. Link also in the description. Is there anything else you'd like to learn in Filmora Pro, or any questions you have about this effect in particular? Make sure to let us know in the comments below. If you're enjoying our Filmora Pro tutorials, make sure to give us a like, and don't forget to subscribe. And remember, there's no limit to what you can create.